Let's go over the definition of the dot product. The dot product is defined as follows. So consider two non-zero vectors, vector u and vector v. Then the dot product of u and v is, okay, so we denote the dot product in this way, vector u dot vector v, and it equals the magnitude of u times the magnitude of v times cosine of theta. Now here, theta is the angle between vectors u and v, and it's an angle between 0 and pi radians. Okay, so one important thing to realize here is that the dot product is a scalar quantity. Okay, so look at this, u dot v, and once again, what it equals is the magnitude of u times the magnitude of v times cosine theta, but all those elements are scalars, right? The magnitude of any vector is a scalar quantity, and the cosine of theta is also just a scalar quantity. So keep in mind that the dot product is a scalar quantity. Okay. So once again, this definition is for two non-zero vectors. So if vector u or vector v are zero, then we have this case down here. The last line, if vector u is a zero vector or vector v is a zero vector, then u dot v equals zero, and that's just a scalar zero. So the dot product is zero, and theta, the angle between the vectors, is undefined. So this is a definition of the dot product. There's actually another definition or theorem about the dot product that we should look at as well. So here's another way of computing the dot product. This is what it says. Given two vectors, vector u, which has the components u1, u2, u3, and vector v, which has the components v1, v2, v3, then the dot product can be computed as shown here. Vector u dot vector v equals u1 times v1 plus u2 times v2 plus u3 times v3. So why is this useful? We've just presented here two different ways of computing the dot product. So why do we need these two different ways? Well, the first method here, this u dot v equals mag u mag v cosine theta. So here you're using the magnitude of the vectors and the angle between them to compute the dot product. But sometimes you actually might not know the angle theta between the vectors. Or that might be actually what you want to find. You might want to find the angle theta between the vectors. So this second expression here in green gives us another way of computing the dot product. So this is really useful. So for example, you could compute the dot product component-wise using this equation here. And then using that, you could actually compute the angle between two vectors.